How can I make a ladder logic program from an existing Arduino sketch or translate it back to a sketch? These and similar questions I have received. So let's take a dive. The PLC ladder programming language is based on the IEC 61131-3 standard. Another part of the standard is the structured text, or ST. The structured text is much like C and C++. Since Arduino sketches are written in C++, we can pattern the sketch to the structured text language. A major advantage of Arduino sketch PLC programming is its accessibility to a lot of Arduino sensors and other peripheral libraries, which are not normally available in standard PLC programming softwares. We are going to consider the ladder logic side by side with the Arduino sketch for ease of understanding. We will use the Outseal PLC Nano and Studio, since the Outseal PLC Nano is based on the Arduino Nano. For this series, you could get an Arduino Nano PLC from JR Electrokit with the link in the description. Or just use an Arduino Nano if that is what you already have. See the video links above for the Arduino Nano PLC overview and how to update the bootloader. For the test demonstration, two push-button switches will be connected to inputs S1 and S2, and then to 24-volt power supply. A 24-volt indicator lamp is connected to one of the terminals of relay RL1 and to the 24-volt terminal. The other terminal of RL1 is then connected to the GND. If you don't have the Arduino Nano PLC yet, set up the connection with an Arduino Nano as shown, with two push-button switches connected to pins A0 and A1, and an LED connected to pin 13. A PLC has three stages of program execution. The first is the input scan, where all the PLC input data is read into the program variables. These input data are used for the PLC program execution, one at a time, from the top left down to the bottom right. The results of the executed program are then sent to update the PLC outputs. We will have to replicate the PLC scan cycle in the Arduino IDE. My assumption is that you are familiar with Arduino programming, or at least have some basic understanding of coding. So download and install the latest version of the Arduino IDE if you don't already have it. The Arduino Nano board and the required COM port number should be selected. We will attempt to write a bare minimum sketch for the Arduino PLC scan cycle. Let us first declare and initialize the input and output variables of the PLC, mapping the Outseal PLC Nano to the Arduino Nano. Above the voice setup function, use lowercase from S1 to S8 to declare and assign the digital input variables to the Arduino Nano pins. Declare and assign the digital output variables from R1 to R8. And finally, the analog inputs for A1 and A2. Then we will declare with uppercase the digital input and output variables as Boolean. In the setup function, we should set the inputs and outputs with the pin mode function. But we will create an IO function to set the inputs and outputs, which we will call from the setup function. The IO function should also have lines of code that should initialize the output pins to zero with the digital write function. So that is it with the pin configuration. Next are the codes for the PLC input scan cycle in the loop function. The input pin status should be transferred to the earlier declared Boolean variables like so. But like the pin configuration, let us create an input function for this purpose. Note that the digital read instruction is inverted with the exclamation mark. This is to ensure the correct input logic states because of the syncing input of the Arduino Nano PLC. Finally, let us create a function to update the output pin states after the logic execution This should be the bare minimum sketch for the Arduino PLC logic. The ladder style control logic should come between the input and the output function. With this, we can commence the replication of the Outseal ladder logic in the Arduino IDE. Download and install the Outseal PLC software if you have not done so. Select your preferred language and then Settings. Give a name to the project. Select the Nano V5 hardware and the PLC port number. Click on Arduino Pinout and note how the Outseal Nano PLC input output labels are mapped to the Arduino Nano board, as with our variable declaration in the Arduino IDE. The simplest ladder program is a contact S1 and a coil R1 on a ROM. Then upload the code to the Arduino Nano PLC. The indicator for the R1 relay is turned on when the push button switch connected to S1 is held down. The same ladder logic operation can easily be reproduced in the Arduino IDE with an if-else statement placed between the input and output functions. It says, if the value of input S1 is true, output R1 should be made true. But if S1 is false, R1 should be made false. This should also be seen when the code is uploaded into the Nano PLC. A normally closed contact can be represented in the sketch using the exclamation mark before the input variable. An inverted coil is represented by swapping this R1 value to false and the other one to true. In Outseal Studio, having two contacts S1 and S2 in series with a coil is an AND logic representation. The coil is only energized when both contacts are logic 1. In the Arduino sketch, I will first swap back the R1 status and logically AND S1 and S2 using the logical AND operator. This will produce the same logic operation as the ladder logic when uploaded into the Arduino Nano PLC. Placing the two normally opened contacts in parallel with a coil in Outseal Studio represents a logical OR operation, which should energize the coil when either of the contacts is enabled. Replacing the logical AND operator in the Arduino sketch with the logical OR operator will achieve the same operation as the ladder logic. When two normally opened contacts in parallel are connected in series with a normally closed contact and a coil, where one of the parallel contacts is an input switch S1, and the other is the coil output R1, and then the normally closed contact is another input S2. This is called a retaining contact, commonly used for starting and stopping operation. When S1 contact is enabled, R1 coil is energized and remains energized due to its contact that is in parallel with S1. Energizing the normally closed contact S2 will break the signal flow and the energized coil R1. The retaining contact ladder logic can be replicated in the Arduino sketch with the logical AND and OR operators and careful use of brackets as shown. When the sketch is uploaded to the Nano PLC, the operation can be seen as earlier described. The set and reset, or latch and unlatch, as it is called in Outseal Studio, is also used to perform the same starting and stopping operation as the retaining contact. For this, contact S1 will latch coil R1, while contact S2 will unlatch the same coil R1. Now let us modify the Arduino sketch as shown to represent the latch logic. For the unlatch logic, these lines are duplicated and edited with S2 parameter and R1 equal false. Uploading the sketch to the PLC will demonstrate turning on and turning off the indicator. In this video, we have recreated ladder style programming in Arduino IDE using the Outseal Studio ladder format. We also created Arduino functions to configure the input and output pins and mapped them to Outseal PLC Nano to read the input status of the PLC and output the status of the program execution. In the next video, we will consider the analog input output and related analog operation in the Arduino IDE. You can order this Arduino Nano PLC from JRO Electrokits using the link in the description. Make sure to subscribe and enable all notifications so that you do not miss out on any of the videos. And hit the like button if you have found this video helpful. See you in the next video.